स्टैंडर्ड 12th. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक दैट इज रिस्ट्रिक्शन एंजाइम्स विच इज फ्रॉम चैप्टर 11 बायोटेक्नोलॉजी प्रिंसिपल्स एंड प्रोसेसेस. Restriction enzymes, these are specific enzymes which cut specific nucleotide base pair of palindromic sequence of DNA. Students, restriction enzyme is a specific enzyme. That is, it is a particular enzyme. It is because its work is to cut the nucleotide base pairs which are specific, that is, have palindromic sequence of DNA. Now, students, here we need to understand that what is nucleotide first. Students, nucleotide actually is a collection of deoxyribose sugar, and nitrogen base, and third, phosphate group. Now, students, the collection of deoxyribose sugar, nitrogen base and phosphate group is called as nucleotide, which you can see here. And this nucleotides specific which remains present in the DNA is being cut by the restriction enzyme, which you can see here. So we can say that restriction enzyme is used for cutting the DNA from particular point where the deoxyribose, nitrogen base and phosphate group remains present in the DNA, and which is palindromic, which you can see. So students, this palindromic sequence of the DNA is also required for the working of restriction enzyme. Now students, let's know what is palindromic sequence of DNA, where the restriction enzyme cuts the DNA. Palindromic base sequence of DNA are the specific sequence which can be read same from either of the sides of DNA. Now students, it's a very important point which we need to know, and that is palindromic sequence of the DNA is that sequence, that particular sequence of the DNA, which you can read same from both the sides. Now, students, it appears difficult to understand, but here with the help of this picture, we can easily understand palindromic base sequence of the DNA. Students, firstly, we should know that this is the strand of the DNA. Now, students, you can see here the arrangement of the nitrogen base, that is guanine, adenine, thymine, cytosine. So the sequence GAA TTC, if the same you read from back, then it will be CTT AAG. And the same sequence, if you find, is present on this strand, the other strand of the DNA, because this strand is also of the DNA. So this kind of sequence of the DNA which can be read from both the sides equally will be called as palindromic base sequence. So we can call this too as the palindromic base sequence to each other, because the sequence remains the same. You can see here G is here, and here also the G is present in the beginning. Here A is there, and here also A is there. Here also T and C, and here also T and C. Finally, so that is why it is a palindromic base sequence. There are three types of restriction enzymes. Type 1 is the specific restriction enzyme which can cut the base sequence at 1000 base pair away from its attachment in DNA. Students, it is the particular type of restriction enzyme which definitely will cut the DNA. It will cut the DNA where it will attach, but it needs minimum 1000 base pairs distant for this type 1 enzyme, restriction enzyme, to cut. So that is, we can understand like this: if this is the DNA and this restriction enzyme attaches here, so this restriction enzyme will not cut the DNA here. Here the restriction enzyme will not cut the DNA if this strand is supposed to be the DNA. So what it needs? It needs at least 1000 base pairs away. Presume this as the 1000 base pairs. So here at the end, this restriction endonuclease or restriction type 1 enzyme will cut the DNA. So this concept will become more clear if you will see this picture, where the type 1 restriction enzyme from the recognition site, that is from the point of its attachment, which you can see here, it is not cutting at the point of its recognition site, rather it is cutting the DNA at the 1000 base pairs distant, that is 1000 base pairs away from the recognition site, which you can also see here, 1000 base pairs away from the recognition site. This is the work of the type 1. And these are the examples: ECO K1, ECO A1, and CFR A1. Students, the problem with this type 1 enzyme is that this enzyme takes 1000 base pairs from the recognition site to act upon. So it will cut the DNA, but it will cut the DNA quite distant from its recognition site. And students, this is why it is written here, you can see it is less used. This is why it is less used, because it will not cut the DNA at the exact point of its attachment. Type 2 is the another specific restriction enzymes which can cut specific base sequence of DNA at the exact site of its attachment. Now students, after understanding type 1, type 2 is very easy to understand, because type 2 is the only restriction enzyme which has the ability to cut the DNA. But it will cut the DNA at the exact site of its attachment. That is, students, it will not require 1000 base pairs to cut the DNA. So if this is the DNA and here the restriction endonuclease, that is restriction type 2, is attached or gets attached, then here only you will find the cut in the DNA, if this is the DNA. So that is why, students, it is written here also that it is very much preferred. Obviously it will be very much preferred, because the scientists were able to cut the specific DNA at the exact site where they made the type 2 enzyme to attach to the specific DNA. So students, this point will become more clear if we concentrate on this picture. Here also it is mentioned type 2 restriction enzyme, which is quite specific within the recognition site. That is, it is the restriction enzyme which has the capability to cut the DNA at the exact site of its recognition site, that is at the exact point of its attachment. Examples here you can find EcoRI, BAM-HI, HIND-3. Type 3 is another specific restriction enzymes which can cut DNA at 26 base pairs away from its attachment in DNA. Now students, after understanding type 1, type 2, type 3 even becomes more easier, because it is the specific restriction enzyme which also can cut the DNA, but students, it require 26 base pairs away, but it requires 26 base pairs minimum for type 3 to cut the DNA. That is, if this is the DNA, students, and the type 3 enzyme attaches here with the DNA, then here, like type 2, type 3 will not be able to cut the DNA. Rather, it will require 26. Presume that it is the 26th base pair. So, although the type 3 enzyme has attached here, but it will cut the DNA on the 26th base pair, which is present in the DNA. So, it requires 26 base pairs minimum for the DNA to cut from the point of its attachment in the DNA. So, students, this point will become more clear from the picture which you can see here. It's written type 3, which takes 24 to 26 base pairs minimum from the recombination site, which I have showed here, to cut the DNA which is being cut here. Examples: ECO, PI, HENF3, and ECO PI 151. At the point of cut in DNA, which is done by restriction enzyme, there is production of either sticky or blunted. So, students, this feature is also concerned with the restriction enzyme. So, when we treat the strands of DNA, then undoubtedly the DNA gets cut at the point of the attachment of the restriction enzyme. But after the DNA gets cut into two strands, the end of the two strands either become sticky or become blunt. Now, students, with the help of these lines, it's difficult to understand it. But with the help of this picture which is presented here, it's very easy to understand. Students, here we can easily notice that there are two strands of the DNA. So, actually it is a DNA which is acted upon by an enzyme, restriction enzyme, ECORI. Now, students, here you can notice that ECORI, which is the restriction enzyme, is cutting the DNA into two. So, if this strand was like this, it is being cut into two. So, you can see here the restriction enzyme is cutting the two strands of the DNA into two. Now, after the DNA gets cut into two, you can easily notice that this part of the DNA, which comprises of AA, TTC, gets separated, which is here, and there becomes a gap here, which you can see in the first strand. In the second strand, if you see where the nitrogen bases were intact, which was C, D, T, A, G. After treating the second DNA strand with the restriction enzyme, it separates. And here also you can find the gap in the two strands. That is, this end which you can see here comes here, and this second end only G remains here, so that there is a development of a gap in between these two. Students, this development of the gap, if it gets produced, then it is called as the sticky end, which is mentioned also in this diagram. But presume that there are two DNA strands and the restriction enzyme is cutting it into two, and both are getting divided or getting cut into two, then students, this will be called, these two ends which you can see in both the strands, strand one here and strand two here of the DNA strand, you cannot find the gap. So this will be called as the blunt end. So this also, if here in the example which you are seeing here, if we have to show the blunt end, how it will be appearing, because sticky end I don't think will be having any problem, but in the blunt end, if any confusion is still there, then if the two strands of DNA has to be blunt, then it has to be like this. If this three remains in this side and this three remains in this side, this three in this side and this three in this side, so that after the division it appears like the gap gets filled with here A, here the gap gets filled with in the bottom here, here T C. So students, if we have to sew the blunt ends, so this will look like this two strand, here it will be G A, and now the second strand will be T C. Here also it will be C T T, and here the second strand will be A G. So students, you can see here in the center there is a blunt space, that is, there is no gapping like here you can find the complete gapping, and here you find the complete gapping. So because of the absence of gapping and the presence of nitrogen bases without gapping, these two strands will be said to be having blunt ends. Now students, let's discuss an important question, that is, what are tools of recombinant DNA technology? Answer: the following are the tools of recombinant DNA technology: restriction enzymes, cloning vector, competent host. Students, because the topic is very lengthy, so today we have studied about the restriction enzymes. थैंक यू स्टूडेंट्स.